They confronted rulers. They confronted rulers, confronted kingdoms and kings until they subdued the forces that were ruling their days. So we are going to look into some of these people's life for 15 days. Each day, we'll look at two people, and we shall be entering into a season of impartation of their mantle, of their mantle. I hear some ministers today who said that what you see in me is not about me. It is a manifestation, it's an expression of a number of mantles which they desperately sought for until they obtained such mantles. So God wants to release mantles, and we shall be looking at some of these men and women, and we shall trust God to deposit in us whatever was in them. Depositing us into us what he deposited, what he invested in the lives of such people. All right, I shall be talking more on this from Monday as we launch into that by the grace of God. Now, today, I want us to look at a few men. We want to look at the life of Elijah, the life of Moses, the life of David, and the life of Paul the Apostle. I'm not going to do a study on that, but I'm going to lead us into prayer in the certain issues that relate to the life of these men I just mentioned. These are some of the fathers of the faith that God wants us to look up to, covet the grace, covet the strength, covet the life they lead, and God will answer as we pray. What you value, you will attract. What you respect, you will attract. We want to place value on the grace, on the grace of God. I worked with these men and these women, and what you value, what you appreciate, what you esteem will be attracted to you. That's how it works. All right. Now, turn with me to the book of James chapter 5 from verse 17 to verse 18. James chapter 5 from verse 17. Thank you, Father. We give glory to your name. James chapter 5 from verse 17 to verse 18. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We give you honor today for what you are said to do in our generation. I read James chapter 5 from verse 17. Okay. He says, Elijah was a man subject to like passion, as we are. And he prayed earnestly that it might not rain, and it rained not on the earth for the space of 3 years and 6 months. And he prayed again, and the heaven gave rain, and the earth brought forth fruit. Now, what do you see in this portion? As I read this portion this morning, the Lord began to speak to me about revival of the spirit of boldness in prayer. Revival of the spirit of boldness in prayer. When you look into the life of Elijah, there is something you see. I saw it in some of these men I'm going to talk about also today. Imagine a man who he has never, I'm sure, as at that time, there is no record of a mortal man that stood up and commanded that there shall be no rain for 3.5 years. What a boldness. If he carried such anointing, such grace, and he refused to stand out and declare it, nothing would have happened. But because he knew that God is with him, and that the God with him is able to do anything and everything, if only he can declare it, if only he can speak it. Now, on this platform, we are charged with a passion, which is to demand that there will be a full manifestation of everything Christ Jesus died for. There will be a full manifestation, a full display of everything Christ died for. It takes faith to pray such prayer and believe it. I want us to pray this hour that the God of heaven will stay in us, will ignite in us the boldness to make, bold declaration or bold demand on heaven. to place demand, a bold demand on heaven, to place bold demand on God. God works according to our faith. God works according to the faith we are able to verbalize. If we have faith and we fail to verbalize it, nothing happens. We saw that Elijah had the faith, the belief that it's possible for a man to close the heaven for 3.5 days, yes, and he spoke it. If he did not speak it, nothing would have happened. But because he spoke it, God had to, affirm it or establish it or action it. And then the Bible said, and he prayed again, and the heavens opened, and the earth brought forth fruit. So we're going to ask God this day. We saw in the life of one of the fathers of the faith called Elijah. He was a man of bold prayer, bold faith, bold demands. He made heaven. He put pressure on heaven. He placed heaven under pressure. He put God under pressure. Even if God was not willing to do that, because of the voice of his son, he had to do that to honor him, to honor his name. So God, give us grace. Give us the unction, the ability to open wide our mouth when it has to do with kingdom matters. Some people have so much faith to ask God for this and that appertain to themselves. But when it has to do with God's kingdom agenda, God's kingdom plan, God's redemption intentions, they have no interest in it. God, baptize us with the interest, with the passion, and with the boldness to pray. Prayer that will affect the destiny of nations, the destiny of nations politically, spiritually, economically, to affect the destiny of our nation. Shall we open our mouth and begin to pray? Lord, we're asking for the grace, for bold prayers. Lord, let this grace come upon all the nations. Let it come upon not just us here, but upon every believer across the nation. Let there be a baptism of the grace of bold prayer, the baptism of the anointing for bold prayer. Let it come upon all the church, in all the communities, in all the cities, in the name of Jesus. Please unmute yourself and let's begin to pray. Dimension of bold prayer. Lord, baptize the church global, baptize the ministers of the gospel with boldness to declare your will, to proclaim that which we understand to be your plan. We see that it is your plan that all men be saved. It is your plan that all men be saved. It is your plan, it is your design, it is your purpose, mighty God, that knowledge of your glory, the knowledge of your will, the knowledge of your glory, your will, may cover the head of the task, cover the sea. It is your will that your kingdom, level down every other kingdom, that your kingdom, the stone cut with that hand, will level down every mountain, every structure, every spiritual setup, every spiritual agenda, every satanic agenda, satanic program, satanic projections, that they be leveled down and flushed back to hell. Father, we decree and we demand that there will be a baptism of that faith of our fathers, the faith of bold prayer. Let it be released upon us. Blessed be your name. Thank you, mighty God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
May I unmute first?
Oh, sorry. I was talking. I didn't unmute. Sorry for that. I said in the first part of that, he said, and he prayed earnestly that it might not rain. He prayed earnestly. There is no revival anywhere until God finds people who will pray earnestly. The Bible said the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous man availeth much. Revival is preceded by earnest, passionate, heart-rending, heaven-rending prayer of righteous men. He said, pray earnestly that it might not rain, and it rained not on the earth, not only in Israel, not only in that territory. He said, on the earth, in the entire universe, not a drop of rain. One man, not a president, Elijah, a man representing the kingdom of God on earth. Lord, fill our nations with Elijahs. Fill our cities with Elijahs. Pour forth the mantle of Elijahs. Lord, revive this anointing, revive this grace, revive this prayer unction upon our men, upon our women, everywhere, the youth in their schools, everywhere, among the professionals, among the career people, among the business people, among the leaders in the government of different nations. Let there be the release of the Elijahs. Let the Elijahs of our days arise again and begin to pray this kind of prayer with this kind of boldness. Shall we begin to pray? Lord, multiply Elijahs across the communities and cities of the nation. Shall we pray? People that will stand strong and shut the heaven until at their word, there will be no rain. And when the command rain will come. Oh Lord, we come, we ask you to baptize us, oh my God. Men and women, Lord, that are desperate enough to hold the control the heavens and control the earth. Men and women that have the grace, the wisdom, the boldness, the courage to control the heaven, to control the heaven and to control the earth, to control the heaven and the earth, to control the heaven and the earth, to control the heaven and the earth, to control the environment, to control the society on their knees, to rule the heavens on their knees. Men and women that have been elevated in the realm of the spirit, elevated in the realm of the spirit, as to rule the heavens and rule the earth, rule the sea, rule the land, control creation, control activities. Lord, we are asking that you baptize us, oh God. You fill us, you baptize us with that kind of boldness in prayer, that kind of boldness in faith, in the mighty name of Jesus. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Quickly, let's go to the book of 1 Samuel chapter 7. Let's go to 1 Samuel chapter 17 quickly from verse 45 to 48. 1 Samuel chapter 15. We are going to pray from this chapter 17, rather 1 Samuel 17 from verse 45. And I read, thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Masuletre Prandesentenegada. He said, then said David to the Philistine, thou comest to me with a spear and with a sword and a spear and with a shield. But I come to thee in the name of the Lord, the God of the army of Israel, whom thou hast defied. This day will the Lord deliver thee in my hand. Deliver thee into my hand, and I will smite thee and take thy head from thee, and I will give the carcasses of the host of the Philistines this day into the fowl of the air and to the wild beast of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel, and all these assembly shall know that the Lord saveth not with sword and spear, for the battle is the Lord, and he will give you into our hands. Now, you notice something here David, you know the story, so I'm not going to tell you the story of David and Goliath. But something caught my attention here, the boldness. One thing is to pray bold prayer. Another thing is to stand out and take action, to take action. Now, we are talking about a global, revival outbreak. There are actions that will match with this dimension of prayer. There are actions, necessary actions, that God would want each one of us as an individual to embark upon, to show that we believe what we are praying. Revival outbreak, global harvest, not just harvest of souls within your immediate environment, globally. God, what step would you have us take? Who are the giants that must be confronted in the different nations and continents of the world? Who are the giants that must be confronted? So our prayer is that God will stay up and revive in us and across the nations the spirit of bold action. It doesn't make sense, the little teenager David going to confront a giant, a man that has been known over the decades to be a champion in the battlefield. He has slain many. He has conquered many armies, subdued nations. But here he stood, threatening the entire army of God. The entire army of God was shivering. Both their prophets were hiding in the caves. I was so scared. And even Saul, the king, whom the Bible described to be head and shoulder above everyone, a giant, he could not confront his fellow giant. But a small boy, David, stood out and challenged this man. It's gone beyond prayer. There has to be action. There's a place of prayer. There's a place of fasting. There is a place of teaching. There is a place of action that brings down the hand of God. I have said on this platform a number of times that if David was blind and with one leg, with one hand, he still would have killed Goliath. All that God needed was a man who, whether it's a boy or a girl, a man or woman, who will have enough courage, enough confidence in the God of Israel to stand out, and he will find a way to kill Goliath that was threatening, intimidating, terrorizing, and humiliating the army of God. Even if that David didn't go with this catapult, with the stone and all of that, even if he didn't go, still God would have caused something to happen to kill Goliath. He just needed a man. He just needed a voice. He just needed somebody who would stand out and speak. So this day we're going to pray, Lord, release upon the church, beginning with you, beginning with me, release upon the church, upon this altar, upon this global harvest prayer network, the grace for bold action. Those who are working in the government, those who are working in construction, say offices, companies or industry, who are working in the financial industry, those who are teachers, those who are in any career or profession, help us to become so bold to stand for you, to speak for you in our territory. The Bible says, since the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and violent women will take the kingdom. Where there is no violence, nothing happens. We can pray from now to the next century. If there are no men and women who are determined to pay the price, to take bold steps like David did, he was not mindful of his life. If God will allow them to kill me, so let it be. But I am going for God, for the name of God, for the name of God's agenda. And because I'm putting my trust in God, he will save me. That's what happened to the three Hebrew children, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. That's what happened to Daniel when he confronted it. Everyone that God used in the Bible, they were men of bold action. They were not afraid of what people would do to them. So, Lord, release upon us, baptize us with this kind of grace, this kind of ability, this kind of zeal, that we will fear nothing and fear no one, but fear the Lord. Shall we begin to pray? In the name of Jesus, please unmute, and begin to pray. Let the kind of boldness that came upon David, let it come upon the church of today, beginning with you. In the name of Jesus, Father, we are asking you, baptize us, O God, with the grace of boldness, with the wisdom to stand out, the kind of boldness which we saw in David, Father, let it be made manifest in our life in this generation. The kind of grace, the kind of boldness, the kind of bold action. Lord, let that grace come upon us. Let the boldness we saw in David, the boldness we saw in Elijah, the boldness we saw in the prophets, Lord, let it come upon us. Let it capture us. Let it fill us to overflowing, to confront the challenging situations of our generation, to confront the challenging Goliaths, of our generation. In the mighty name of Jesus, Malika de Sopranagadiatras, Lebram Dosu Gadikete Nagadusetra, Lebram Dosita, Lina Apoto Igande Prata, Liam Dosu Prenazia, Din Pran de Soto Nogodiatra, Lebrenagadiente Pro. To Santana Gadieta, Legam dosoto upon Jose Prades Trenagadietre Siete, Lempram dosoto por Dunanke Pata, Legam dosoto por Godose Gade Pata Siete, Lempram dosoto por Godose Tresh, Lempinagadiate, Pondo, Sopata, Lende Robondo Siete, Legade Magadicate, Gadicate, 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 Procoto Sietra, Lempratesiete Naha, Gen Dopoto, Sopo, Tomandilahi, Cordobo. Cordobo, legade, zenepatazo, legade cate do brono bondoma criende soto bondonaha triende, le bradicate negadabatiente procotu setresh, le prenagadicate negaduzia, trambo do soto, jante ne patanica de gadicato seprata. God, have your way. We receive the boldness. We receive the boldness which we saw in David. We receive it on our behalf. We receive it for this altar. We receive it for the church. We receive it for your church all over Africa. Let the spirit of the boldness that was in David, let it come upon the church of Africa. Let it come upon the church of Europe and the UK. Let it come upon the church of Australia and Oceania. Let it come upon the church of Asia. Let the spirit of boldness come upon the church. Come upon the church of North America. Let it come upon the church of South America. In the mighty name of Jesus, let it manifest upon the church, upon those who placed in position of leadership. Those who place a position of leadership in the different sectors of the society, let it come upon the men, let it come upon the women, let it come upon the youth to rot riot for the kingdom. To cause trouble for the devil, to slay the Goliath, that are terrorizing the people in the different sectors of the society. Be thou exalted, Father, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Please, I want you to follow me to the prayer number 3. The Lord laid in my heart something this morning. You know, he was giving me a picture of the lion and the lamb. Now, let me read something in the book of Numbers, chapter 12, verse 3. It says, now the man Moses was very meek above all the men which were upon the face of the earth. Wow. Moses was very meek above all the men which were upon the face of the earth. That is serious. Now, this man, the Bible described to be this meek, was the same man that terrorized the entire Egypt. In those days, Egypt was the world power. Egypt was ruling the world. So the Pharaoh of Egypt in those days was like you can't say that America is ruling the world today. Any nation can challenge America. Any nation can challenge China. But in those days, it was either Babylon Egypt or whatever. Now, but in this case, the king of Egypt God raised Moses, whom the scriptures describe as the most meek man, yet he terrorized the entire nation of Egypt. That anytime Moses was coming to Pharaoh, there would be commotion, there would be crisis. Moses has come again. We are in trouble. We are finished. Of course, God said to Moses, I will make you God before Pharaoh. I will make you as God to Pharaoh. He was meek, but as he was like a god. He was meek, yet he terrorized the whole land. Little wonder the Bible made us to understand that when the early church began, anywhere they went to, the people were scared to death. They were scared to death. They were crying out, these men that turned the world upside down, they have come to our land. What do we do? Where do we run to? What do we do? That was how they terrorized the world. Yet he was meek. So the Lord was showing me this morning the face of a lamb. Lambs are known for meekness. Meek, yet was a lion. A lamb, yet a lion. Now look at the book of Revelation chapter 5. Revelation chapter 5 from verse 5 to verse 7. Now that's where I'm going to, let's complete that story there and then we'll get into prayer. Revelation chapter 5. From verse 5. Am I right? Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your name. All right. He said, and the one of the elders said unto me, weep not. Behold, the lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, has prevailed to open the book and to loose the seven seals thereof. And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne and of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders stood a lamb as it had been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirit of God sent forth into all the earth. The seven spirit of God sent forth into all the earth. From who? From the lamb that looked like it was slain. All right, that's describing Jesus. That's describing Jesus. Now look at verse 7. And he came and took the book out of the right hand of him that sat on the throne. Now remember, it was said that no man, verse 4 said, and I wept much because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. That was the vision God showed to John. There was this book sealed with seven seals, and no man was able. This book contained life itself. This book contained the revelation of the things to come, of the mighty moves of God, the redemption moves of God, the wonders that God is about to open up and unfold. But it was sealed with seven seals. Inside of that book was the documentary of what God is about to do, what God is about to do in the remaining years and decades of this earth here. They were all contained there. I was there. You were there. The great moves of God with you, the great moves of God with me, they were all contained inside that book. But it was sealed. No man was able to open the book nor to read. Then the lion of the tribe of Judah was found able. This same lion, when he saw him, he was like a lamb. So he's described as a lion, but when he saw him, he was like a lamb. So how could this lamb looking like weak, is sick, or looking like a slain lamb, yet he commanded a presence. He carried the seven spirit that illuminated the entire world. He carried the seven spirit of God that came into all the earth and brought massive revival, that brought fire upon the earth out of the lamb, who is also a lion. I want us, therefore, to pray. Time will permit me to go much into this. I want us to pray, Lord, release upon us on this platform, beginning with you, and every brother, every sister here, and every servant of God across the nations of the world, release upon us the spirit that makes a man, that makes a woman to carry dual nature, the nature of a lamb and the nature of a lion. It speaks of meekness, it speaks of humility, and it speaks of, boldness, kingdom boldness. The Bible said that Jesus Christ humbled himself and became a servant Paul said, I make myself all things to all men. I make myself all things to all men that I might by all means save some. He said, to the rich, I come as if I'm a rich man. To the poor, I come as if I'm a poor man. All right. Now, that is, you know, that side of him. And then the other side was becoming like a lion, a lion, a lion. I remember reading a book by Ben-Hinn, and he said that God told him, my son, for you to fulfill your mission on earth, you need to go and study under Archbishop Benson Idahosa of blessed memory in Benin City of Nigeria. You need to learn his boldness. Learn boldness from him. Learn boldness from him. Because in this kingdom, to excel and to prevail, especially in this end time, you need to gain the dual nature of Christ, the humble side and the bold side. Without it, you can't go far with heaven. You can't go far with God. So this is part of the attribute of the spirit of our fathers, and we must go for it and possess it. Boldness and humility all mingled together, making you like a mystery, like a God in the land of the living. At the same time, you are of the meekest of the earth. This is what God is calling our attention to. So I want us to pray, Lord, help me to be a bold person and at the same time, a very meek person. And let this character possess all the evangelists and pastors and prophets and bishops and teachers and musicians and all the people of God across the globe. Let this same spirit capture every one of us, that in us you will see boldness, the kingdom kind of boldness, the kingdom kind of violence, at the same time as meek as the dust of the earth. Shall we begin to pray? Please open your unmute, and let's begin to pray. Begin to pray. It begins with you. It begins with me. It begins with this altar. It gets to the entire world. In the name of Jesus, my Father. In the name of Jesus, my Father. Bando soto, bande ne capre canto poco to set, Leganda bata sopo to nacatiate poco to setra, Prodogodobodia tropro crotos yet, Legande patos, Leganda batusa, Legana batusa, Le bande cato poco to sente, Mande braga to setrenagata. Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask you for the grace, O God, to manifest the spirit of the lion and the spirit of the sheep. In the name of Jesus, obey as bold as the lion, as bold as lion, and as innocent as a dove, in the name of Jesus, as innocent as a dove, as innocent as a dove, mighty God, as wise as serpent, as wise as serpent, as innocent as a dove, oh yes, Lord, and as bold as lion, as bold as lion, in this end time, Lord, fill us with the spirit of the lion, and with the spirit of meekness, with the spirit of meekness, and spirit of meekness, the spirit of meekness, I pray thee to come upon us, to come upon us, and to come upon the church. Come upon the church. Lord, release upon the church the spirit of meekness and the spirit of boldness. Oh my God. Lena Supata Sietre, Renagadieto Procoto Setre Shepata, Le Gadabanusa, Le Gade Caprodos, Pinatre Sietre, Le Brada Gadabanagadietros, Precata Pantigadi Gadabato Setenazo, Sambantoso, Pudi Capata, Lembando, Subanata, Subanata. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. To take this last prayer, and that is taken from the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 32. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 32. I read from here. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Mazu pata lisi entresh. Le bramdo sepata. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 32. Where is verse 32? Good. He said, if after the manner of men, I have fought with the beast of Ephesus, what advantages it me if the dead rise not? Let us eat and drink, for tomorrow we die. Now, something caught my attention in this. Brother Z, can you put it in another translation? Let me see what it looks like. He says, I have fought with the beast of Ephesus. In 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 12, he was saying, say, fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, wherein thou art also called. Now, he fought a good fight. He told us to fight a good fight. And when he was finishing his mission on earth in 2 Timothy chapter 4, he said, I have fought the good fight and I finished my course. I have kept the faith. I have fought the good fight. I have finished my course and I kept the faith. I fought. He first told us, fight the good fight of faith. And he told us here how he fought with the beast of Ephesus. He fought with the beast of Ephesus. Now, my prayer is, Lord, help us to gain the capacity, to gain the wisdom, to gain the intelligence to fight the beast of our generation. Every city has a beast. Every community has a beast. Every generation has a beast. There must be a people that are prepared to fight the beast of their generation. There are a people that must be charged like Paul the Apostle, to fight the beast of their own Ephesus. Please pray this prayer. Lord, help me to see the beast I am sent to fight, the beast that I'm sent to behead, the Goliath that I've been anointed to behead for the kingdom of God. There is a beast, this altar is called to behead for God, to destroy. There is a beast God has called, the church of every community, every nation, every ministry has a mandate. There is an assignment. There is a beast to fight and to destroy, because we are not just called to just to be good people. No, we are called to wrestle against principalities, against powers, against the spiritual wickedness in high places. God, anoint us with confrontational grace, confrontational, contending and fighting grace, contending grace, contending faith, confrontational faith, fighting faith. God, fill us with it. Fill us with it. Fill the church of today with the kind of grace that was in Paul to fight the beast of every territory. Wherever you are walking, there is a beast you must fight there. Wherever you are planted, there is a beast you must. If you will not contend over that beast, nobody will contend over it. Shall we begin to pray? Please unmute yourself and pray. This is our last prayer. Father, male egade e pradunan gambadine krapotosen de kapratasiente. Lembrena Gadabadiente Pocoto Sente Nagata Badiente, Legata Badoso, Ubande Sata, Iladanos, 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 Soba, Tenago, Sonapaya, So Brando, So Matajende, La Dica Ipoto, Igada, Ilaga, Idombo Soto, La Ringa Pragato Sente Pragato, Petre Krakrabatosio, Lembradicate Nagata Badiento Pocoto Setre, Father, in the name of Jesus, to receive the grace, O God. yet to confront the beast, the beast of our generation, the beast of our city, the beast of our families, the beast of our family, the beast of our territory, the beast of our generation. We receive the grace to contend and to destroy, to fight with the beast of our generation, to fight with the beast of our generation, and to subdue them, to conquer them, to prevail over them, to prevail over them. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, the oil to confront the generation, the grace to confront the beast of our generation, the mantle to confront the beast of our generation, the unction to confront the beast of our generation. In the mighty name of Jesus, we receive that grace, we receive that wisdom. Have your way. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Open our eyes. Open our eyes. Help us to be discerning. To discern. Receive the ability to discern. Help us to discern. To discern. To see the beast we must confront. Help us to discern. To discern. Ability to discern. Ability to see. Ability to understand. Oh Lord, the fight we are meant to fight. The battle we are meant to fight. For you. For you. In our lifetime. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. I want us to pray into our meeting next week. Like I said, next week is set, I call it from Monday, it's 15 days of encounter with the mantles of our fathers, of the fathers of revival. We shall be opening up this history of some of the revivalists. Each day we handle two very briefly, just key things to say about them. All right, and then we go into taking hold. I'm going to be telling us by Sunday, I'm going to send a message to tell us what the two fathers of revival we shall be praying about their mantle on Monday. All right, and then when we are finishing on Monday, I will tell us the two we will be praying over for Tuesday, so that you begin to pray for it, charge up yourself, study about them, prepare your heart for the releasing of the mantle, for the catching of the mantle that worked in the life of those men and women. We need them now. There have been revelation of mantles dropping, mantles dropping, mantles dropping. I've heard that from different gatherings, that God is saying from 2021, he's going to be dropping mantles of the fathers that departed. So we want to use the rest 15 days, all right, to take hold of that. So please prepare yourself. Shall we begin to pray that God will honor you, honor me, honor this altar. Let there be encounter with the mantles of our fathers and the mantles of our mothers as we begin to gather from next week. Shall we pray that prayer within just 1 minute in the name of Jesus? Father, we commit, oh God, the remaining meetings we have, the remaining 15 meetings we have this month, Oh God, I'm asking you for the release of this mantle. Lord, prepare our heart. Thank you for the verses you use. Be thou exalted. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, pray. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be God. Blessed be God. The Lord laid in my heart that on Friday we should be praying for people whose birthday or wedding anniversary falls into the week. So is there anybody that this week, beginning from Sunday, last Sunday, this Sunday that passed till Saturday, is your either birthday or wedding anniversary? Please, you can indicate so that we pray for you. Anyone? If there is any, you can raise your hand, or you just unmute yourself and let us know. Okay. Anyone? All right, so I assume there is none. Let's take our communion. Please lift up your communion element. I want us to speak into this communion. And we want to use this communion to provoke the graces that we have discussed here this morning. The grace of bold prayer, the grace of bold action, the grace of being a lamb, at the same time, a lion, the grace of confrontational and contending faith. Contending and confrontational faith to slay the beast of our territory, the beast of our family, the beast of our family, the beast of our industry, the beast of our workplace, the beast of our city and our nation, the beast, the grace to slay the beast. We want to activate it even through this communion. I want you to begin to pray. Take up your communion element and begin to pray into it. Lord, as I partake of this communion, let there be the activation. Let there be the activation of every grace that has been prayed over here. Let it be activated in my life. Shall we pray? Mighty God.
Oh God. Let it be the God Almighty. Let the word only the blood of Jesus, the Holy Spirit, and the be a catalyst
Let it be activated in our life. Thank you. I will exalt the Lord forever. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Go ahead and partake of the bread and the wine.
Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus. Thank you. In Jesus' name.
Thank you for the privilege to stand in the holy place, to burn incense on this altar. We give you praise. We give you honor. We give you adoration for everything you have done. Thank you. I want to ask Brother Z to pray for the people who have ministered on this platform this week. Pray for those who, not just those that led prayer, but everyone that ministered, that prayed, you and I, everyone. I want you to pray prayer of blessing, a prayer of covering upon everyone. Just pray as the Spirit gives you utterance.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Father, we just want to give you the praise. We give you the glory, oh Father God. Mm. Father, we thank you this morning that it is not of us, oh Father God, but it is according to the Spirit that works in us, oh Father God. I thank you, Father, for every minister on this platform, oh Lord God, for every intercessor, oh Jehovah God, for everybody that availed themselves, oh Lord God, on this platform, Father, to call upon your name, oh Lord God. Father, I release right now, yes, your blessing upon them, oh Jehovah God, that even these prayers, oh Father God, will not be in vain, oh Father God, because we know that your ears are open unto the prayer of the righteous, oh Father God. Father, we come, oh God, this week with an expectation, oh Father God, that every prayer that was prayed here, oh Jehovah God, it will not return to you void, oh Father God, but every word that is spoken, oh Father God, it will accomplish everything that it has set to accomplish, oh Father God. Father God, I pray, Father, even for your blessing upon each individual life here, oh Jehovah God, even as the ministers, oh Father God, have taken care of the business of the kingdom of heaven, oh Lord God. Father, I pray right now that you may also take care even of their business, oh Father God. They may not have come and prayed, Father, concerning their own wants and needs, oh Father God, but you know what is needed, oh Father God, in each and every life that is presented here, oh Father God. Father, I pray for the meeting of needs right now in the name of Jesus. Father, where there is lack, I release abundance, oh Father God. Father, where there is sickness, I release divine health, oh Father God, in the name of Jesus. Father, I bless you. I worship you, Lord God, that even as we go into this weekend, oh Father God, in the name of Jesus, I pray that your presence, oh Lord God, will go with each and every one of us, oh Father God, in the name of Jesus. us, even as we go about our Father's business, even as we go into action, oh Father God, according to the word that you have heard here, oh Jehovah God. Father, we pray that you may go before us in our services, in the churches, oh Father God, in our ministries, oh Father God. Let your presence, Father, be with us right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you. We give you the praise, Father. We give you the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Thank you so much. I want to thank every one of you and appreciate all of you for standing with Jesus Christ. You didn't come to stand with Pastor Light. You came to stand with Jesus Christ. The Lord commanded me to raise this altar for men and women across the globe to stand with him, to give people privilege, opportunity to stand with him, to enforce in every nation that which he died for. So I want to congratulate you and appreciate you on behalf of Jesus Christ, who owns this altar, for standing with him. And I want you to know that he that watereth shall be watered. God is not ungrateful and he is not unfaithful. What he said he will do, he will surely do. So
amen.
He that laboreth for the kingdom shall labor for him. The Bible says, he that reapeth receiveth wages. You are watering the ground and preparing the ground to harvest the souls of men. God will pay you wages in different ways, tangible and intangible ways, both now and in generations to come. This seed you are sowing, your children and children's children to the third and fourth generation will inherit and benefit from the abundance and the overflow of the benefits of this you are doing. May the Lord bless you and cause his face to shine upon you and make you an outstanding testimony of a woman, of a man, of a family that served God sacrificially and unconditionally. And God exalted him, exalted her to a global acknowledgement that people from around the nations will testify how God defended you, how God fought for you, how God honored you, lifted you, favored you, beautified you beyond your widest imagination, that you will become a testimony of the faithfulness of God, a testimony of the blessing of God, a testimony of a woman, a man God is using in this present day. This is our prayer, and so it is, and so it shall be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. The grace. May the grace
of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God,
and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now
and forevermore.
Amen.
Amen.
And forevermore. Amen.
Father, we thank you for those who fast on Fridays, who fast on Saturdays, who fast on Sundays. I pray for them and I cover them with the blood of Jesus. Let your hand be mighty upon them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please remember that beginning from Monday, we are embarking on a very serious matter. 15 days of encounter with the mantles of the fathers of revival. Prepare yourself for it from the beginning till we end this month. It is impartation of mantles. Get ready, study about them, and capture the mantles. And God will use you to take what they did to another dimension, to the glory of his name. All right, goodbye, and see you on Monday. God bless you.
Thank you,
Pastor Lars.
Thank you so much, people of God. Thank you.
Okay.
Hallelujah. Thank you, men of God.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone, and bye.